Hello, everyone. I'm Ryan. Welcome back to Hero Siege. I don't even remember where I'm at, and I only played this game yesterday. Okay, no. I definitely know I was Ol' One Eye, the old mining village. That's right. It was a brand new act. And here I was saying I was only going to do the boss battles. I don't know. This one has a very Tristram-like feel to it. Can I go in this house? Door's open? Nope. What are you? Little impy guy. Do I have any keys? I do. Oh my god, I can... Whoa. I can go in there right away? It's kind of funny. I thought those normally happened after the waves were over. Anyway. It's a good day today, I gotta say. Wait, I shoot fire? Oh, wait, no, I don't have any relics. That would be the... This... Where is it? Yes, the mythical Hellfire Torch. Okay, let's see. Let's just get some armor and then get the hell out of Dodge. Okay, there we go. In the old mining village. But it is a... I hope you guys are having a good day, too. I'm having an awesome one right now. I mean, a lot of reasons, I guess. Let's run through the gamut, shall we? Okay, after I've avoided a laser. There we go. Death lasers are not part of a good day. That much I can say for sure, but I mean, I know. Looking outside, it's a blue sky. Iron Fist just got released on Netflix, and I've been looking forward to that. A lot of people apparently been bashing it, but I mean, like, you know what? I like it so far. It's a hero that, I mean, I pride myself on knowing a lot about Marvel, but I got to admit, Iron Fist is one that I am not very well versed in, so learning a bit about that lore, it's pretty cool. And of course, I mean, you know, now that he's in the mix, we're ever closer to the Defenders, and that's going to be pretty sweet. Luke Cage, Jessica Jones, which, Iron Fist and Daredevil. It's going to be pretty awesome. Actually, I think there's a Punisher Netflix series coming out too, isn't there? What's this potion do? Stamina increased. Hey, one that doesn't almost kill me. Righteous. Can't wait to see what the boss for this level looks like. And as I said yesterday, looking into, I'm going to be doing a very long, long playthrough of The Long Dark. Like I said, it's going to be in... What would be the right word? Pursuit of the 200 days achievement, because that's going to be long. But I recently played the game yesterday, like obviously not recorded because you don't need to see how bad I am at that. I did like one or two episodes long time ago and it wasn't terrible, but they've changed the game quite a bit. They've added a lot more to it. And I realize it's kind of funny that I'm talking about that game while playing a completely different one, but I wanted to get this out of my mind before it just slips away. They've changed some things, at least in terms of like the survival aspect, the weather dynamics, your stats, like, I mean, your the layout, the interface. Even the menu system is a little bit different. They've even got a more hardcore survival mode where I think like the tagline at the beginning was like, you are not part of nature's plan. It doesn't want you here. The conditions are gonna get worse. You're gonna die. I don't know if I'm going to choose that difficulty for the 200 days one, because that seems like it might be a bit too brutal. I'm the guy who loves super hard difficulties in survival games. The 200 days one, that might make it not impossible, but very tough. Either way, what I'm getting at is my plan is to go through the story mode, do a let's play the story mode, because there is one, and I didn't check to see if that one's completely finished yet. But go through that as kind of like a practice run to hone my survival skills in the game. Because again, it's been a while since I played it, so I'm very rusty. And goddamn, do you ever get hypothermia fast in that game. So, I figure go through the story mode, see what that's all about, get used to the environments. Because the only one I'm very familiar with is the Mystery Lake level. And there's like four or five new ones now. And I believe if I understood the descriptions right, they're all kind of interconnected. Oh, speaking of interconnections, there's a boss battle. Where's the pentagram? There it is. What are you going to be, another pushover? Oh, hey, another abomination. There we go. We're done. Now, where was I? Ah, yes. Okay, so I want to get used to the levels, get used to the mechanics again. There's a crafting system that hasn't changed too much, but it is still there. They've added some more elements to, like, heating yourself and fire and all that loveliness. So there's a lot to get used to, but I'm intrigued. I'm excited. Hey, toxic gas. That's fantastic. Glad I didn't get that to begin. It's a mystery one. Oh, what's it do? Speed increased. Yay. I'll take that potion too. Looks like mana. To the next portal. Where are we now? The Highland Mines. Hmm. Yes, very has a very Sisterhood of the Sightless Eye progressing further towards Andariel's friggin' catacomb level feel to it. I know I keep referencing Diablo, but that is the vibe I'm getting here. And to finish my thought on the Long Dark, after I practice a bit, we're gonna try going for 200 days. Like, there's a part of me that really wants to do the hardest difficulty, because then it's like, well, if I can beat the game on the hardest difficulty and get the 200 days achievement, I'm awesome. At the same time, there's kind of a worry that if I do that, I'll never friggin' finish it, at least with the intention of getting the 200 days achievement. So maybe go for the one that's like a step down from that, just so it doesn't last too long. I mean, don't get me wrong, I'm fully aware that even though it will be 200 days, I think episode-wise, depending on the length, it may not necessarily be 200 episodes, but the thought in my head right now is to go like this. Have it where, oh, there's another potion. Energy increased, I'll take that. Have it where I'm doing like Let's Plays for different games, as I do here, usually to, I'd say, close to completion, or as much as you guys would need to see. Is that the right way to say it? As much as I think would be interesting without getting too repetitive. He says as he goes through the same wave grind he has for two other acts. Anyway, but do different games, and then the consistent one would be The Long Dark, because that one's not just like, oh, we're going to have a whole lot of fun playing this game. It's like, yeah, we're going to have a whole lot of fun, but this is in pursuit of a friggin' pain in the ass achievement. I mean, I would assume that even on the easiest difficulty, the 200 days one, that could be a tad bit dicey to pull off. Gonna find out, though. Looking forward to it. It's gonna be fun. May have to, not 100% sure, may have to beef up my computer a little bit, because even on low settings, that thing can really chug along. We'll see, though. Oh, really? Just a little zombo? A tiny little skeleton? That was sad. Is he dead? Okay, you can stop. Stop. God damn it, Osteo. You gotta keep beating on them even after they're dead, huh? You are a cold SOB. This is a different kind of level than I'm used to. Mining State A. Okay, I'm glad I'm recording this because this has changed. I mean, before it was like, go to one level, fight through a couple waves, beat a boss, hop out, bing, bang, boom, you're done. And that hurt me. Of course it did. And now we've got tikis and dragons. Interesting. But now it's like, go through one wave. I don't know, I guess it's like a bit more traditional in that sense, kinda. It's just, it's not what I'm used to from this game. I'm used to, you know, go through like four or five waves, kill the boss, move on. This is getting a little bit more streamlined. Maybe it's a little bit more, you know, traditional in that sense as the game goes on. I'm gonna have to wait and see. Although, I'm thinking, because I actually do want to finish this game to completion. I was debating, like, you know, we'll let it go. You've seen enough. But I actually kind of think, I want to see how this plays out. So this may end up, in the end, being a collection of cutscenes of final boss fights. But we'll see. If the levels keep staying interesting like that, like, you know, between this one and the pyramids, it's been pretty damn entertaining. Like, goddamn tiki people. Okay. Okay, you guys gotta stop exploding. What are you eating? Oh, that was close. All right, are we done? Three more guys. Where are the three? Show me the three. You're one. I asked for three. Now two. Come on. Where are you at? Okay, I see one of you little red dots over there. Stop moving. Just take your cannonball and go to bed. Where's the other guy? There's one more. I know there is. It says so. Okay, you're on the upper level. I don't know if I can even get you. Nope, I can't get him. Can my skeleton? Wow, that is super annoying. Okay, is this level kind of unwinnable now? Because I sort of feel like, you know, maybe it is. I can't touch this guy, and I don't... Okay, I gotta wait for my mana to recharge. I don't even have the mana to cast a spell that could kill him. So this is happening, huh? Okay, if I shoot the fire, is that gonna be enough? Nope. Cannonballs can't get up at him. Wow. Really? Okay, well, there's a broken piece of this game. Guess I'm going back to town because I physically can't touch the guy. What a piss off that is. You know, again, I'm a little less upset when I'm fighting an enemy that legitimately is kicking my ass. That's fair. You know what? He's just too damn strong. I gotta grind a bit. Fair enough. That's expected. That comes with the territory. I'm not too PO'd about that. Obviously, I get annoyed when I get, you know, curb stomped by death multiple times or by death to the revenge. But when it's something like, oh, he's on a plane that you physically cannot get to and none of your attacks are going to hit him. And oh, by the way, your moves are so strong now that you don't even have enough mana to cast them. So, you know, bend over. Like, what the hell? Oh, good, my stamina's increased. That's great. I can run faster around a place I can't hit him with. It's going to be fantastic. Mining Site A, 14. Okay. Let's try and do this right this time. See, that is the one nice thing. It's not like I was coming back to a situation where I was out and out screwed. I did know that, yeah, okay. If I town portal out, we're going to have to start this wave over. But at least he won't be on, you know, a plane I can't touch. Be totally different if there was a ladder. There should be ladders to get up there. I don't mind them on being on another level than me, in any sense of the word, but don't friggin' railroad me by putting him literally out of my reach. That is a piss off. I got another magic potion. A lot of useless apparel, too. Well, I mean, you know, I do like to buy my fair share of relics. Oh, there's more enemies down here. And these guys never count against the total you have to kill. They're just like an environmental hazard. Which, I mean, it's fine. Do we fight a boss in this one too? A crypt appeared. Really? Oh, wait, no, that's not. I thought it was like the throne crypt. It's just a regular old crypt. Nothing special to see. Okay. All right. Ooh. Got some more fancy stuff. And more tiki gods. Okay. Well, screw it. Let's go into this crypt. There could be some interesting gems and jewels to be had. Wow, this is quite the setup you guys got here, huh? I really don't want anybody showing up. Well, okay. Did you see? Sometimes the items get picked up and sometimes they don't. Is this the ladder? This is. Oh, it's the ladder out of here. Okay. Well, you know, exploding tears. Oh, I've got another friend. Man, I'm making friends all over the place, aren't I? I got a skeleton, I got a parrot, I got an eyeball that does something. Not 100% sure what, but we're going to find out. I'm going to find a name for you. Keys! Speaking of eyeballs, do you know those guys? Are they friends of yours? Relatives, cousins, brothers, estranged? You son of a bitch! Are you on another level? You are, aren't you? Oh my god, I hate you. So very much. Okay, maybe if I move off screen, it'll like reset him. I'm gonna hope that's the case because if I have to town portal out of here again just so I can kill you, well, kill you and all the friends you'll bring with you because, you know, apparently while I was out, you decided to throw a party. You son of a bitch. I really can't touch this guy. Okay, maybe the trap can kill him. Okay, this seems to be working. Something's going on here. Come on. There we go. Okay. I'm not sure if it was the explosion or the spiky ball. Either way, I don't care. It did what I wanted it to do. And do we get a boss this time? Well, that was weird. How come the last one, like, showed up instantly? And this one's, like, doing the traditional wave thing. Thought you changed, game. I thought you changed. You haven't changed. You're the same bum you always were. Me? I rock around with a crew consisting of a skeleton, a parrot. Wow, I couldn't remember the name of a bird. That's impressive. Not like the wow, that's so cool kind of way, but just like, really? You couldn't remember what a parrot was? I didn't actually mean to go into that crypt. Holy crap, did I not mean to go into that crypt. Oh well, thank god all you guys were weak sauce. I mean, you can understand why I was shocked. The first thing I expect when I appear in a new room is not to be railroaded by a bunch of decomposing lycanthropes. Armor up, a damned buckler. Damn buckler. Being all half bent and not blocking all the arrows, you Son of a bitch. Why'd you do it? Why'd you have to not be a good shield? Oh, ah, sheesh. Okay, so the eye lasers slow me down, too. All right. Ha. Oh, I wonder if those guys are like beholders. These old dragons are kind of derpy. I find them funny. What if I'm never going to fight a real dragon? Tja, wonder what the next boss is going to be. There's the real question. I'm more interested. Like, these guys are just like, all right, I have to kill you. You're wave fodder. Fair enough. But it's the boss that I'm curious about. Like, what are we going to have to deal with this time around? And more importantly, what kind of stupid, lousy, one-shot move is he going to have up his sleeve? That's what I'm curious about. What is it that he's going to use to kill me in one blow? Is it going to be something that he opens with? Or is it going to be something a little more like, I don't know, like the first one where it'll kill me, but he's going to teleport me into a situation where if I move, I die. Well, I guess as it turned out with the death one, it was if I moved and then didn't move the right way, I would die. I mean, the possibilities are endless when it comes to, you know, act-ending boss bullshittery. They master in that, you know. That is a skill. It is learned, and it is hard to master. I can say that with full confidence. I imagine Death had a lot of practice one-shotting people. He's been at the game for quite some time, which there's actually a very good question. I've killed two Death Gods. Now, are they just the people who collect souls, or do they kind of preside over Death? Because if that's the case, I really, you know, shouldn't be able to die. Like, maybe that's why I keep coming back, actually. No, wait, I was doing that beforehand. Got a lot of questions about this fantastical world, which I am questing through. I mean, is it just here for me to acquire crap and sell it so that I can buy even better crap? Because that's a bit too much like a metaphor for life, and let me tell you right now, I am not too keen on that. So come on out of your pentagram so I can kick your ass, then go to the next level, kick his ass, and then finally get to the end of the level and kick the main guy's ass. No? You're gonna hide behind your tiki gods? Fine. Fine. I'll kill them first, then I'll kick your ass. Seriously, you guys are really... You're really freaking pacing this out here. You're making me angry. You're making this more difficult on me. Like, I would be happy enough just going in and fighting you. No, no. No, 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 no. You gotta send out old Three-Eye to fight old One-Eye because you don't got the balls. Well, let me tell you something. I'm going to be camped outside this pentagram until you haul your abominable ass out of the depths of hell so that I can roundhouse kick you in the face and send you right back. I'm going to just wait out the clock because apparently, you know, it's a fixed time. You don't start before or after. You start exactly when you're supposed to. Now, there you go. See? We're on schedule here, all right? No lollygagging. No gold bricking. What are you? A tree? A tree. You sent a tree. KO the sapling. Yeah, I will KO the sapling. There, he's been KO'd. Are we good now? Can we go to the last boss? Because that would be great. Oh, it's the basilisk tooth. I remember the basilisk tooth. It's been a long time since I've had the basilisk. Wow, this just got nightmarish super quick. Okay. Suddenly missing the mines. I mean, they were brown and boring, but at least it didn't look like, I don't know, American McGee's Alice in Wonderland. Oh, complete with demon mushrooms. Look at that. Yeah, okay. Well, I can't get out of here soon enough. I'll tell you that much right now. Let's, okay, blow up the giant demon skull head, and there are pools of purple goo. Yeah, no, I think I'm just gonna pop down here for a hot minute and buy a fresh, tasty relic to bring to bear. Oh, hey, Rupture. I've lost you like 5 times so far. How you doing, buddy? The nightmare. It is the nightmare. Not a nightmare. The nightmare. Like, it's the worst possible nightmare you could ever have. Whether that involves, like, I don't know, having to give a speech naked in front of your high school class or running through the sewers from some sort of horrible clown. God damn, those mushrooms are creepy. And this is coming from a guy who's fought a lot of disturbing stuff in this game. The mushrooms really wig me out. I don't like them at all. It's the teeth. Something about the mouth. It's just... I mean, then again, I suppose giant mushrooms walking at you is unnatural anyway, but the teeth really just hit it home for me. It's like, I'd rather not. Does this hurt? Yeah, that just hurts. Okay, I thought it was like the goo the maggots would throw and it would slow me down. What the hell is this? Oh! Okay. Wow. Creepy green apple that spawned into a giant skeleton head. Yeah, I would like to say I am surprised, but no. No, I'm really not. I'm not saying you guys are, like, you know, starting to get boring on me, but when shit happens that I cannot explain, I don't even attempt to figure it out anymore. I'm just going with it. What is with that creepy apple? That's probably the one mystery that I want the answer to that one, if nothing else. Forget the secret of life. I just want to know what that creepy green apple's all about, because, man, I don't think fruit should smile. That's just a personal belief. You can agree or disagree, but when I go to the produce section, the last thing I want to see is my fruit smiling at me. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Is that what the basilisk tooth does? Like, when it turns people to stone, it petrifies them by encasing them in a giant demon apple? I mean, I kind of thought basilisk just had, like, you know, a stone stare, a petrifying gaze. But, you know what? The history books don't always get it right, kids. Apparently, it's got nothing to do with the eyes. It's got everything to do with spitting a projectile at them, which encases them in an evil apple. And you can take that to the bank. We'll increase the chance of exploding bullets. I say bring on the explosions. I say we don't have enough explosions. Okay, and maybe I shouldn't take swan dives into pools of purple goo. Where is the... There's the pentagram. Okay, right in front of me. I'm waiting. No, wait, this has only been two waves. You're not going to show up, are you? Yeah, I got a funny feeling. Well, no, in 3 seconds when it just craps out more enemies, so come on. Poop them out. Where are they coming from? Up here? Good. Fine. Evil mushrooms? Evil bees! What a delightful, horrible forest this place turned out to be. And spiders! Spiders. Arachnophobes would hate this place. I really don't feel one way or the other when it comes to spiders. Now, if this were an ocean level, maybe so. Not a big fan of the ocean. Not that I'm afraid of water per se, but I don't know. Particularly when it comes to open bodies of water like the ocean, I'm just overwhelmed by this feeling that it does not want me here. I can't breathe, everything in it has teeth and moves faster than me. I just feel like I should be anywhere but there. Lakes are kind of okay though. Water I can see through is not too bad. I mean, you know, streams, rivers, don't mind canoeing. Ocean? No thank you. Way too worried about that. Seen too many movies where ocean adventures go bad. Come on now. Come on. You got 2-1 boss. Nope, wave. Okay. We'll get through you first then. Not even going to let you get off screen. We are on a time limit, people. There's a schedule here, and I'll be damned if we're going to screw that up. No. Ah, walked right into spiders. Didn't even notice it. Shouldn't you guys be dropping webs to slow me down, too? You're not even doing that. You walked around. Whoa, okay. Camo mushrooms. That is new. That is an interesting tactic. Okay, now there should be a boss, because I think it's every 4 waves. Wave 83, huh? Man, oh man. Can't even tell which part of the act I'm on. I think... 1, 2, 3... I think this is like the 4th act. So the 5th one's where the dungeon... The throne dungeon's gonna appear. So not this one, but the next one. Which I'll have to wait until the next episode, because I think I'm running a little long in the tooth as it is. Could you get out of here? I gotta finish this episode. Dazul, did I not kill you before? Are you coming back for round 2? Let me shoot you a little extra so you stay dead this time. Yeah, go ahead, Osteo. Get a couple hits in, too. I don't care. Alright. So, we got a bunch of gear. Blah, 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 blah. You're all gonna pay for my college debt and a few extra relics. And to the final portal, which is... The Devil's Breach. Ooh, it's a castle too. That's fancy. All right, well, I think that's as good a place as any to call it quits, because the next episode, unless my calculations are horribly off, we should be going to the throne dungeon, and you get to see me die instantly again, as happens with all the bosses, because that seems to be the trend I follow in Hero Siege. But until I do, hope you guys enjoyed this episode. And as always, oh crap, let's just hide behind a brick wall for a second. As always, my name's Rye. You guys take care of yourselves.